Namaste everyone, this is Dr. Pratibha KS, Head Department of Biotechnology at KLE Society SES, Nijalingappa College, Rajendranagar, Bengaluru. Today I'm before you to present a lecture topic on denaturation of proteins. Denaturation of proteins refers to the changes in the properties of a protein by chemical or physical agents. This chemical and physical agents brings the loss of biological activity of the protein. Denaturation action is not strong enough to break the peptide bonds. As you know, as we are studying here, denaturation of proteins, protein molecules are the building blocks of amino acids, right? Individual amino acids which are bound together through the peptide bonds, right? Here, these chemical or physical agents are unable to break the peptide bonds, okay, in the polypeptide chain. It means they are able to break only the other bonds which are present in the proteins. For example, here protein structure in the sequence of linear amino acid, here this primary structure remains the same after the denaturation process, because in primary structure, in most of the primary structure, you will find only the peptide bond. So this denaturing agent, like chemical or physical agents, are unable to bring the denaturation process the primary structure. But denaturation disrupts secondary structure, tertiary structure, and quaternary structure of proteins and uncoils into random shapes. Denaturation followed by coagulation or precipitation. It means denatured protein molecules tend to form large aggregates. Okay, let us go to the definition of denaturation of proteins. Denaturation may be defined as the disruption of the secondary, tertiary, and quaternary structure of the native protein, resulting in the alteration of the physical, chemical, and biological characteristics of the protein by a variety of agents. Here you can see this is the folded protein, right? These folded proteins, upon treatment of denaturing agent, this will become unfolded proteins, and there is no specific shape and they will lose their biological activity. So this is the reaction after the denaturing agent. Here also you can see, for example, alpha helix can be seen in the secondary protein after treatment of the denaturants like acids and bases, heat, alcohol, reducing agents, or heavy metals. You can see the denatured polypeptide chain, okay, where they do not specifically show any kind of the specific shape. Here also you can see this is the normal protein where you could see the foldings, okay, foldings and refoldings can be seen here. After the treatment of the denaturing agent, physical or maybe a chemical agents, there will be a loss of biological activity due to their loss of native configuration or conformation. So this is the denatured protein. But some of the proteins that can also be subject for the renaturation, okay, regains its activity, and that will be possible with only certain proteins, but not with all the protein molecules. For example, crack an egg into a hot pan. Egg white is made up of the protein albumin. When albumin is in the raw egg, it's coiled up in its normal three-dimensional structure. The heat from the pan, however, will cause the protein to unfold or to denature. It means heat which is going to bring the denaturation of the proteins. Okay, this heat which act like a denaturing agent. As it denatures, its properties change, right? Its native configuration will change. The complex proteins will become into simple one, and that will be easy for a human being to consume those protein molecules. You can see denaturation happening as the egg white turns from its translucent form in the raw egg to opaque white form of the cooked egg, and that will be good also for the consumption purpose. Okay, now let us go to the mechanism of protein denaturation. Unfolding of native proteins occurs at both the temperatures. At higher temperature, denaturation occurs, means it is called heat denaturation or thermal denaturation. And if denaturation occurs at low temperature, then it is called cold denaturation. In both the cases, there is a breakage of hydrogen bonds, disulfide bonds, hydrophobic interactions, van der Waals forces, but there is no breakage of peptide bonds during denaturation. Okay, so you must keep in your mind that, as I mentioned here, many bonds, all these bonds can be seen in the protein molecule other than peptide bond. I'll repeat for you: hydrogen bonds, disulfide bonds, hydrophobic interaction, van der Waals forces, all these bonds will be broken down on treatment of the denaturing agent. It means all these bonds are responsible to maintain the stable configuration of the protein molecules. All these bonds get disturbed or broken on treatment of the denaturing agent, and they will lose their biological activity. For example, this is in the active state, okay, protein configuration. Then this is in the inactive protein after treatment of the denaturing agent. Okay, so for example, in the previous slide I've given the example of the egg albumin, right? So this, when we put that one to the hot pan, their complex proteins will be broken down into simpler one, and that will be good for us to consume. Okay, now let us go through the physical agents. Physical agents, in the sense that is mechanical action, like shaking, which brings the mechanical action. Heat treatment disrupt the hydrogen bonds and nonpolar hydrophobic interactions. This occurs because heat increases kinetic energy and causes the molecules to vibrate rapidly and violently. That time what happens? Bonds are disturbed. The proteins, eggs, denature and coagulate during cooking. Other foods are cooked to denature proteins to make it easier for enzyme to digest them and to break also. Medical supplies and instruments are sterilized by heating to denature proteins in bacteria. Thus, we can destroy the bacteria, right? Heat treatment, which is going to destroy most of the bacteria once they denature the proteins. Okay, proteins can be absorbed in all the plasma membrane, right, and in the cell. So once proteins get denatured, cell will not be surviving. So we indirectly we are going to destroy the bacteria by the heat treatment and high hydrostatic pressure, UV rays, all which comes under this particular physical agents. Now let us go through the chemical agents. Ionizing radiations like X-rays, then radioactive and aromatic anions like salicylate, ultrasonic radiations, organic solvents like acetone, okay, then anion detergent like SDS, sodium dodecyl sulfate, and some certain enzymes, strong urea solution, acids, alkalis, okay, which brings the denaturation. Let us take one example, alcohol. So alcohol, which is going to break the hydrogen bonding, which occurs between amide groups in the secondary protein structure, also 3' protein. Okay, structure, that is tertiary structure. Okay, 70% alcohol used as disinfectant on the skin that able to penetrate bacterial cell wall and denature the proteins and enzymes. Once the cell wall is broken or denatured further, the cell will not be able to survive. So this alcohol disrupts the intramolecular hydrogen bonding, which brings the which makes the hydrogen bond breakage in secondary structure of proteins and tertiary structure of the protein. Acids and bases disrupt salt bridges or ionic bridges. Heavy metal salts that has the high affinity and attraction for sulfur, silver, lead, cadmium, okay, and other metals with high molecular weight are reducing agent disrupt disulfide bonds and split it apart. Okay, since salts are ionic, they disturb salt bridges in proteins, and reaction of a heavy metal salt with the protein leads to an insoluble metal protein salt. This reaction is used for its disinfectant properties in external applications. For example, silver nitrate used to prevent gonorrhea, that is STD, that is sexually transmitted disease. Infection with the bacterium Neisseria gonorrhoeae, it tends to infect warm and moist area of the body like urinary bladder, eyes, throat, vagina, anus, female reproductive tract. Gonorrhea passes from person to person through unprotected oral, anal or vaginal sex. Numerous sexual partners also possibility will be there. Infections in the eyes of newborn babies or infants will be treated with silver nitrate. Used in the treatment of nose and throat infections as well as to cauterize, that is burnt wounds. Mercury salts are administered as mercurochrome, similar properties in preventive infections in wounds. Commonly, proteins get denatured upon shaking and heat treatment that leads to unfolding of the polypeptide chain responsible for disorganization of the internal structure of the proteins. When peptide chain or protein molecules unrolled, certain bonds split and exposed to the action of proteolytic enzymes. Okay, which brings the hydrolysis and responsible for disruption of four types of cross linkages which are present in the proteins, which are responsible to maintain the stable configuration of the proteins. First one, hydrogen bonds, disulfide bonds, salt linkages or salt bridge, or ionic or electrostatic bond. Hydrophobic bonds are non-polar hydrophobic bonds. Some proteins, when denatured, cannot brought back to their original state. In that case, denaturation is irreversible type, and other hand, denaturation in other protein is of irreversible type. For example, if trypsin, which is a protease enzyme found in the digestive system, which brings the hydrolysis, is exposed to a temperature of 80 to 90 degrees Celsius, which brings the denaturation. When the solutions cooled at 37 degrees Celsius, the activity of protein enzymes regains, which means that is the renaturation. And this is possible only with certain protein molecules. I hope you understood today's concept, denaturation of proteins. I, Dr. Pratibha K, signing off for today. Stay tuned with me. I'll be back soon with another video. Thank you for watching and thank you for being with me. Thank you.